So hello everybody and welcome to this ELIXIR webinar. I'm Rafael Jimenez, the Chief Technical Officer at the ELIXIR Hub. And today I have with me some company. So I would like to show you who is with me. So we got Roberto Prese. He's a junior developer at the ELIXIR Hub. And he's involved in the community work. He's going to be more involved in the community work of BioSchemas. We have Martin Cook, in case that you haven't seen his face. He's working as a leading web developer at ELIXIR Hub, and also he's chairing the life science event group at the BioSchemas. And we have Premi Silbelek.
Hello.
Premi Silbelek is communication officer at ELIXIR Hub, and he's chairing the community group at BioSchemas. Okay, so in this presentation, I'm going to introduce, we are going to talk about BioSchemas, and I expect that it will not take more than 30 minutes. So BioSchemas is a project, is a community initiative that is participated by organizations, umbrella organizations like Goblet, like ELIXIR, BRI, Epistoy Alliance, BD2K, and also projects like BioSharing, BioCaddy, TESS. So many different communities, many different projects that are involved and are supporting the project. So BioSchemas is about, it's a project about structured data for describing content that we have in the life science. So it's an initiative that is very based on schema.org, and this is a popular standard or initiative that is supported by main search engines like Google, Yahoo, Yandex, and well, like BioSchemas, schema.org is working on defining structured data for content types. So in BioSchemas, we have started to work with specific types that are related to the promotion of bioinformatics and also types that are related to training. So these types are events, training materials, organization. But also we've been starting to work on the idea of how to use BioSchemas for biological entities. So you will see later that, for instance, one of the types that we are trying to work on is biological data sets, and we have the BioCaddy people and the BD2K people involved in the definition of these specific data types. Let me go to the next slide. Okay, so I mentioned structured data several times, and I thought it was worthwhile to give a definition of, or to show what is my understanding of structured data. So structured data for me is a standard way to annotate content, and content that can be accessible in a programmatic way by people, by tools. And this is what we are going to talk about in this presentation, structured data and structured metadata. So what is BioSchemas? I mentioned that this is an initiative, is about structured data, metadata. But for me, if I had to define BioSchemas in a few words, this would be the definition. It's a specification on top of schema.org. Schema.org is kind of providing a model, a data model, and we are building on top of that model. So what BioSchemas is bringing is an extra layer of quality, compliance, and support that facilitates the users to expose the content with the structured data, and also facilitates the work of tools and people that want to integrate that information. So you can see this picture. So I hope that you can see my mouse. I'm highlighting the specification. We have the specification, and inside the specification, we have the data model that is based on schema.org. And what BioSchemas is bringing is a layer of minimum information. So we are defining the properties that are important for us in schema.org. We're also defining control vocabularies, basically the terminology, words that are important for us to describe properties. Also cardinality, and the cardinality means how many times a property should appear in the data model. So for instance, you will expect to have one title and many keywords. And something that we are doing as well in this specification is we are looking for the missing properties that are important for our community. Besides that, something that we thought it was important to have in these specifications is documentation and lots of examples, and I will show you a little bit more about this in the coming slides. So this is a representation of our specification. I just cut it and paste bits of the specification. So you have the title there, you have a screenshot of the data model, and below you have a screenshot of new properties. I put on top of this a layer to show again what we are doing. So you can see in red we have the data model, and this data model is actually inherited from schema.org. So on the left we have the different properties that we are using to define one specific type, in this case Allied Science event or an event. And for every property you have information about the type of property that it is. It could be a string, could be an integer, it could be an object, and at the same time you have information about those properties. So this is provided by schema.org. We are relying on that model, but you can see on the right with the different colors what is what we are adding to that data model. So we are trying to define the cardinality. So for instance, end date, you can see end date there. Basically, we are expecting just one end date. We are also defining the minimum information. So for instance, the end date we think is something that should be in every description of an event. But we have different types of minimum information. We have minimum information, properties that should be recommended, properties that are optional. And we have another layer that the control vocabulary. So what we are looking is at the different properties that can be described with a vocabulary. And sometimes this vocabulary is specific of life science. So for instance, we can have a topic, an event could have a topic, and the topic could be metagenomics, genomics, and et cetera. So we are also suggesting with control vocabularies we could use to describe properties. So below, you have their new properties. So schema.org is providing a lot of properties to describe types, but by looking at the information and the feedback that we get from our domain experts, we found some properties that we think are worthwhile, and this is something that we are using to improve the schema.org model as well. So something that we have and I'm very proud of is that in our specifications, we have lots of examples and lots of examples that are related to life science. And I think the examples is the best way to drive adoption of any standard. So you can see this is example number 6. So I think for the events specification, this is a very good example of how we are trying to drive the specification. Okay, so we have different specifications and different groups driving the specification. So we are trying to build a bit of community within BioSchemas. So we have the event group, the training material group, the organization, the person, the standards, the data sets, the commons, and the community. So you can see the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 groups are related to deliver specific specifications. And the last two, the commons and the community, are more groups dedicated to, well, the commons to look the commonality, the common properties across different types, and the community to build the BioSchemas community. Okay, let me go to the next slide. Okay, so I like this representation, and this is what kind of symbolize what BioSchemas is, and actually our logo came from this slide. Every triangle represents one specification. So we have events, organizations, the training material, standards, people, and we will have more. And for every specification, we have minimum information, so properties that are relevant and important for one specification and for the life science. And something that we are trying to do is to look within that minimum information, those common properties, properties that are common across all the types. So I think this is very interesting and very important for us, because this can facilitate the linking and also the contextualization of the different types. So this could facilitate as well the search for common properties, like we could search for events and standards and organizations that are classified with one specific topic and has been published with one common date, for instance. Okay, so I really thought that I couldn't explain much about BioSchemas without introducing a little bit schema.org. So I want to show you how schema .doc can be useful and it is useful. So a very brief introduction with four or five slides. So schema.org is an initiative, as I was saying before, supported by the main search engines, Google, Yahoo, Bing, Yandex. And it's about structured data markup for web pages. And as I was describing before, for me, what the schema.org is providing is a model for describing content types. So this is an example for the recipe type. So as I was saying, it's a data and metadata model. So on the left, you have all the properties of recipe, and I just made a little bit bigger some of the properties so you can see them. So as I was saying before, on the left you have the properties, in the middle the type of property, and later the description. And this is what is provided by schema.org. So how this is used? So you can see different website providers. They have different entries, and this is an example for a recipe. This is the recipe for a classic potato salad. So you can see that they have quite a lot of information there. And what schema.org is doing is trying to standardize the structure of the content behind the scenes. So basically, the front end is not affected by schema.org properties. They are invisible, but in the code, in the HTML, you can see the schema.org properties, how they are trying to structure and define what is meant by ingredient, what is meant by calorie, etc. So the good thing about this is that for Google, but not just for Google, for any programmatic access tool, it's very easy to go to the HTML and to actually get structured content. So how this impacts Google? Well, Google or any search engine, Google and the search engines can understand much better the different web entries, and because they understand much better, they can represent the information in a better way, so they can create the summaries that we have on the right. But also when they display an entry, they understand the entry, so they can display better that entry in one specific context. So in this case, for instance, it shows the title, but with the image and the cooking time and the calories. So this is very, very good, and well, as soon as you understand a little bit the content or the data, you can present it in a better way. So there are many types in schema.org. I don't really know how many, but lots, and this is growing almost every few months. And well, surprisingly, or not surprisingly, there are not any biological types, and this is something that we are thinking within our community. This is a little bit of information about the evolution. So I think schema.org is justified because no all the databases have a programmatic access interface, but I think almost every database or any resource, data resource, provide content in HTML as a web entry. So web entries are not, as I was saying, are difficult to crawl, and because normally they don't provide this structured data, and schema.org is trying to change that. So an HTML page can be a graphical user interface, but at the same time, with schema.org can be now an entry that you can access programmatically. I think something that is interesting, Guha and Dan, they published this article in December, and I think they were screening a set of web pages, and they saw that 30% of the web pages are schema.org compliant. So this is actually growing, and it's kind of becoming a standard for describing web content in the web. So I think something that is important for search engines like Google, and also for BioSchemas, is community agreements. And I think this is what is the basis for schema.org. And I wanted to show you an example. So something that happens in our community is that our community is interested to get agreements and to describe things in a common way. Actually, in bioinformatics, this is something that we have been doing for a long time. So for the types that we are dealing with in BioSchemas, the events, the training materials, the organizations, so we have different discussions. So this is a discussion that happened within Goblet. Goblet is the global organization for bioinformatics learning, education, and training. And well, these people did meet, and actually they were very good because they were analyzing how they were providing event information, and they were collecting the properties, and they were comparing the properties, and they even came with agreements. So I think it's very interesting that they came with agreements, but I think something that they didn't manage to do is to convey that agreement to the rest of the people. And I think schema.org is a good way. It's the perfect way to reach the rest of the community. So anyway, so this is a little bit the results that they came up with. So they basically look. I have a better slide for this. So on the right you have different websites. So they were analyzing the different websites and the different properties that were provided by different websites, and they look at the commonalities, and the different organizations try to agree on what was the best way to represent event information. So something that we've been doing in BioSchemas is to look at all these agreements, the agreements that came from Goblet, the agreements that came from ELIXIR, the agreements that came from many different communities for the types that we are dealing with, that are the training materials, the events, the organizations. And we collected those agreements into one specification. So we didn't try to say what was important for us. We just rely on the feedback from the domain experts. And once we create these specifications, some of them are still under construction. So we share these specifications with our communities within BioSchemas to see if everything that we have done is right. And afterwards, we look for feedback outside BioSchemas to try to reach agreements of what is important for us in the life science. So all of these agreements, again, and all these properties, we try to align them to schema.org. So once we do this specification with examples, with documentation, with the control vocabularies and everything, we try to see if there is anything that is missing that should be reported to schema.org to try to improve that data type. And by improving, it could be many things. It could be the addition of new properties to schema.org, or it could be the proposal of a new type that could be extending a very basic type of schema.org. So we are looking at different ways to improve schema.org and also our own specification. So at the end, what we aim is to publish and actively promote those agreements and schema.org as a standard. And something that we are planning as well is to have like different reviews and versions for the specifications. Okay, so I wanted to show you a little bit what we can do with this. So schema.org is really good. So different web entries can provide information with schema.org, and that's fantastic. So so I think we are working on different things, and I think they follow. At the end, I kind of managed to concentrate or to draw this this slide that represents the general concept that facilitates integration and search. So we have different content providers, so the green boxes, so they can adopt all the schema.org, and then we can have Google that will search and will index this content anyway, and we have specific systems that are tailored for integrating this information. So the user can go to Google, that is a generic browser, to look for this information, and it will direct to the final content. Or you can use something more sophisticated that understands better the data and has better faceting of the information to be able to access this information. So one example that we are working in ELIXIR is the test portal, is the ELIXIR training portal. So what we are trying to collect is training materials using schema.org, and we are trying to aggregate that and to facilitate the searching and the access to this information. Okay, so yes, so I've been explaining schema.org and BioSchemas for specific types that are not related to biological types. So many people have asked us, and what about biological types? What about proteins? What about genes? What about protein structures? So this is something that we are looking at. Actually, we had a meeting last week to talk about this. So I think this is a topic that is a little bit more controversial. So we did probably the easy part, that it was probably to deal with the simplest types, and now we are trying to engage the community to see if it makes sense to push BioSchemas and schema.top for biological types. So I think the feedback that we got, it was very positive. So we got many organizations involved in a meeting last week. So the meeting, let me put the next slide. The meeting was focused on metadata searching, and it was very focused on schema.talk. So we have brainstorming sessions. We have had a lot of presentations and also hands-on. And something that we want to do is to use the structure of ELIXIR and B2K as a way to try to get agreements on how we can do this together. So you have the link there to the meeting, so you can see a little bit the outcomes of the meeting. We are still processing, and we will make them public. So something I wanted to say is that in this meeting we have representatives from major databases. We got representatives from people that are doing integration at a high level, and also we have even representation from Google to help us to shape an idea or ideas that can help us to push this idea of biological types for schema.org. So I would like to do a little bit of publicity as well, and in case that you are interested in this topic. So we are going to keep discussing the topic of schema.org for biological types in FORCE11, in a FORCE11 meeting. So it's FORCE 2016 Searchathon, and this will happen 17th of April in Portland in the States, and you have a link there to the meeting in case that you are interested. So a little bit more of publicity. BioSchemas is involved in the Google code with BioJS. So BioJS has been accepted as an organization, as a participant organization of the Google Summer of Code. And we have an interesting proposal about visualizing standards and schema .org types using BioJS and the specification of BioSchemas. So you have a good proposal and you're interested, or you know people, your students that are interested, please encourage them to apply. We'll be very looking forward to see how we can improve visualization as well for standard types. So that's all from me. I wanted to say thank you very much to many people, especially to the BioSchemas community. I cannot name probably everybody that has been involved, but I would like to highlight the group chairs. So the community chair, that is Prem, the event chair, that is Martin, the training materials, Alexandra and Gabby, the organization, Richard Holland, the person chair, Niall Bird, the standards, Alejandra, that I can see that she's in the call, and also Peter, and the organization representatives that you have them listed there. Okay, good. Yes, so thank you very much for your attention, and I hope that you understood and you know now what BioSchemas is, and that you get so excited as I am and you want to join right away this community effort. Thank you very much. So if you have any questions, I will be happy to answer any of them, and also have my colleagues here that will be able to help me.